SCTV now begins its programming day. Starring John Candy, Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin, Catherine O'Hara, Harold Ramis, and Dave Thomas. Television like you've never seen before.
I'm Floyd Robertson, and this is the SCTV News. My colleague Earl Cannonbear is on a trip to New Delhi to investigate conditions there, and we'll be speaking with him as soon as we get a hookup. In the meantime, today's lead story, another earthquake rocked the small country of Togoland today, shattering homes and buildings throughout the entire eastern part of the country. Damage was once again estimated in the millions. We have that special report now from Earl. We have the hookup. So come in, Earl Cannonbear in New Delhi.
Thanks, Floyd. I'm here at Goldie's Delicatessen on 8th Street.
You idiot! You're supposed to be in New Delhi.
It is a New Delhi, Floyd. It just opened last
India! Week. India!
Get back to the studio right now.
Would you like me to bring you back a pastrami?
Get back here right now. Just a minute. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Delhi.
Good morning and welcome to Political Sciences 101. I'm your instructor, Dr. Hammond Greer. Today I'd like to talk to you about the future of the scientific community. Consider these facts, culled from a recent magazine article. Fact number one, 90% of the scientists who ever lived in history are living today. Fact number two, 1 out of 4 people in the Western world works for the scientific community. And yet this secret society exists because each year, and this is fact number three, the government gives the scientific community billions of dollars and millions of barrels of oil. Why? Why is this allowed to happen? When it is a known fact that scientists are stealing from us. Proof? You want proof? Weigh your car. Then compare that weight with the weight listed in your owner's manual, and you'll find a discrepancy of 50 pounds. 50 pounds times 10 million new cars built in North America every year. That's 500 million pounds of steel and glass. What are they doing with all this stuff? What are they building? They got enough to build another planet, which is probably where they live, off on some planet, whipping around the universe, doing who knows what to whom. And then these scientists say they can't get us better mileage on our cars. Well, we'd be getting great mileage on our cars if they didn't steal our gas. Yeah, they sneak into our houses at night with rubber hoses and siphon gas out of our cars. And that's not all they're stealing from us. My toaster is working slower than it ever did before. It's because the scientists are stealing electricity, siphoning it out of my home without even asking me. And I know I get more mail than I do. But the scientists steal it, open it, and read it. And if it's no good, then they send it to me. And how many times has someone phoned you and said they tried to get in touch with you, but your line was busy, and you know you weren't on the phone? Because the scientists were using your phone, probably making long-distance calls to that planet they live on. And who do you think takes the top one-third of all cereal boxes? Scientists! They love cereal. They're stealing from us. They're robbing us blind. And what do they give us back in return? Proper pH balance for our hair. What the hell is proper pH balance, and who cares anyway? We gotta stop them before they take over the world! Tomorrow, we'll be talking about the effect of the gas combustion engine on the political structure of Taiwan.
Are you wheezing, coughing, gagging, choking because of dust, soot, smoke, smog, and particles in the air? Yes, air pollution's getting worse, and that could spell respiratory problems for you. Well, now you can do something about it with the amazing new Robco Up Your Nose Pollution Filter. Yes, these incredible new filters fit snugly in any standard nostril to trap dangerous air pollution before it reaches the respiratory tract. Nose hairs just aren't enough. This magnified view of an unfiltered nostril shows nasal hair clogged with pollution. And here's the same nostril after only 3 days using the incredible Robco Up Your Nose Pollution Filter. So don't wait another minute. Protect yourself with the fabulous Robco Tobacco Up Your Nose Pollution Filter. Available in all kinds of different sizes, such as small, medium, large, extra large, and even colossal. Make breathing a lot easier with the Robco Up Your Nose Pollution Filter. Available at cheaper stores everywhere.
And now, SCTV Action Line with Francesca Reams. Francesca?
Thanks, Floyd. This week's letter comes from Mrs. E. L. Kimpton of Broadview, who writes, "Dear Action Line, I've got a real problem. The international arms race is driving me completely buggy. Besides being a threat to world peace, it's really a big waste of money. Do you think you could do something about it?" Well, Mrs. Kimpton, we have done something about it. Action Line contacted a Mr. Leonid Brezhnev in the Soviet Union, and we got the following reply. "Dear Francesca, we had no idea that our arms buildup was causing such a big to-do. Please tell your viewers we're disbanding our armies and shutting down our arms plants immediately. Sorry for the inconvenience. Sincerely yours, Leonid Brezhnev." Well, another happy viewer. If you've got a complaint or a problem, why don't you write Action Line in care of SCTV? Next week, we'll tell you how Action Line solved the problem of rising oil prices. So until then, this is Francesca Reem saying, Floyd.
Food and Drug Administration today released results of tests they've been conducting over the past 10 years. Now, these tests, in essence, substantiate the theory that you are what you eat. Dr. Jennifer Colby, in charge of the program, gave SCTV News this exclusive report.
We wanted to see if the nutrition found in certain foods and not found in others has a direct causal relationship to human behavior and intelligence. And we think we've proved our point. This gentleman was fed a diet of cola and cheesies 4 times a day, every day for 10 years. His name is Walter. Walter, do you like cheesies?
I like them.
Our next subject is Stu. Stu was fed a 12-ounce steak 4 times a day, every day for 10 years. Stu, how are you feeling?
Shut up or I'll rip your face off and shove it down your throat!
You'll notice that he's somewhat aggressive.
I hate your stinking guts! You want to fight? Come on!
Our third subject, Sarah, was fed a megavitamin diet consisting of vitamin B compound, E calcium lactate, halibut liver oil, and brewer's yeast in 2-pound dosages per day, every day for 10 years. There has, as you can see, been some hyperactivity of the pituitary and other growth glands. Subject number 4, Stasiu, a Polish steelworker from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, was fed tea and crumpets at breakfast, lunch, 4 in the afternoon, and just before bed. Subject number 5 was fed a diet of worms. Subject number 6 was put on a water diet.
Oh, what the hell are you looking at?
So, as you see, science has proven that you are what you eat.
Oh, hi, I'm Johnny the Roo. Sitting here in kind of a tropical paradise in the fabulous Tang Gardens. As you can see, the decor is lovely, and it's just a beautiful place. I got here a little early this afternoon because the proprietor is a good friend of mine, Mr. Lin Yi Tang.
Hi, everybody. How are you?
We like to get together over some wild rice wine and talk about the old days. I'm looking forward to this meal because Chinese food is my favorite. So let's begin.
Yeah, my favorite too.
Come on, let's go.
No.
Yeah.
I'm ready to serve you now, sir.
Well, I'm really hungry, so let's get going.
Hungry? How could you be hungry? You've been eating all day. Okay. Welcome to the Tang Gardens. Here's the menu for you.
Good.
Yeah, but before we order, may I freshen up your drink a bit?
Oh, you sure can, because this wild rice wine is delicious. Let's see, I'm really hungry. And this is just a beautiful menu. It's got all sorts of great dishes on it.
Yeah.
I think I'll have my favorite, which is Hopin Yai Toche.
No, you don't want that.
Oh, I really do. I know it's filling, but I'm hungry. I'd
you
like
don't
that.
Want that. Come on.
I do want that.
All right. There you go. Hey! You said throw some noodles on your head. That's what you said.
Well, I guess if you can't speak Chinese, your best bet is to order in English.
Yeah, but I got a suggestion for you. May I not order for you to help you?
What?
May I order for you?
Oh, yeah, that's a great thing, because here at the Tang Gardens, the staff is courteous. And they'll help you pick real Chinese food out, not this tourist junk that you get.
Not just that. We help you by cooking the food hot at your table. That's what I'm going to do for you. Okay.
Excellent.
I'll be right back. You don't go away, all right?
No, I'm going to stay right
here.
Oh, and send over some fortune cookies, too. I love those fortune cookies.
Here you go. Hey.
He's a funny guy. You know, you can always tell a good Chinese restaurant by the number of Orientals who eat here. That's a tip from Johnny the Roo. You can just check that out for yourself. That guy, hey, you! He's Eurasian, that guy over there. He's a great guy. Oh, here comes the food.
Man, watch out for the knife. All right.
Look at all this delicious food.
Yeah, it's great, huh?
I'm looking forward to this meal.
Yeah, and not only that, you're going to help prepare the meal at your table.
Yeah, this is a treat right
here
at the Brown Garden.
Brown rice here.
Brown rice.
Yeah, you brown it.
All right.
Like the oil, okay? All right.
So
now,
what do I do? Just brown it?
Yeah, brown the rice. I'll chop up the vegetables.
I'll put a little.
Okay, you better hurry, though. I'm running out of time.
A little wine in the food is always good to have. And I need a candle here. This will light the sucker. There we go.
Oh, look out!
Holy jeez!
Keep it off you. Come on. We gotta get this out of here. I'll take it away.
Boy, that was really hot.
Yeah, we're out of food now.
I guess I wrecked that one. But there's lots more food here at the fabulous Tang Gardens.
No, there isn't any more food. You ate it all, remember? You clean us out every time you come here, Mr. LaRue.
I need to order some burgers in or something.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'll go get some more.
What's this over here?
Well, these are just some sprouts. You can graze on them if you like.
Oh, excellent. I love sprouts.
I'm going to the bar to get more white rice wine.
Great. Okay, well, I'll join you if you want.
Yeah, all right.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, my show isn't rigged.
I can't believe I made it through this. I'm so drunk, I can hardly see.
These things do happen here. But I'm
going to
give this place a 5-star rating anyway, because it's one of the best Chinese food places anywhere in the world. So this is Johnny LaRue saying, happy dining.
Mr. LaRue! Mr. LaRue! Somebody call a cab.
What's wrong, Zeke?
It's these darn hemorrhoids. I mean, they're really bothering me.
Having problems, big fellow? Try one of these.
Who was that masked man, Emmy? Left me the silver bullet.
That's not a bullet, Zeke. That's something wrapped in foil.
It's all soft. I wonder what I'm supposed to do with this.
Sit on it! Hi-yo, silver!
This is Perspective 77. I'm Lou Jaffe in Belfast. This is a troubled city whose problems continue amidst a climate of hatred and intolerance. But here at Sullivan's Pub, something is being done about those problems. Mrs. Eileen Tierney has formed a group called Peace Through Dialogue, and its purpose is to have Catholics and Protestants sit down and actually confront their differences using modern encounter group techniques.
Well, yes, well, that's exactly what I'm saying. You're not allowing yourselves to open up to say, I respect you, I love you, you're a part of me. Now, come on, work with me.
No, we're just trying to live our lives.
Yes.
To do our jobs.
Oh, yes.
Is that right, John?
Yes. We are trying to live our lives and work on that. How you feel?
Who ordered the stove?
I'll
tell you, I was a little bit ashamed myself to be laying my feelings down on someone else. But now I feel it's important that we share these feelings.
Share them with each other.
Catholics and Protestants and Jews.
Yes, Father.
We all have to learn to live with each other.
Live with each other.
Mrs. Bloom, she's married to a non-Catholic.
Tell us
about it, Molly Bloom.
What's he like?
Well, he kissed me under the Moorish wall. And I thought, well is well, him is another.
And then I put my arms around him. Yes. But first I asked him with my eyes to ask again, yes.
Yes, yes.
And then he asked me what I...
Yes,
yes. To say yes, my yes. Lord, to flounder. Yes. Yes. And drew him down to me so he could feel my breast.
Yes. 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 Yes.
But his heart was going like mad.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes, I said. Yes, I will. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
To help ease mounting tension. Whether it works or not still remains to be seen. I'm Lou Jaffe. This has been Perspective 77.
Hello, Mr. O'Connell.
Oh, hello, Mrs. O'Reilly. How are you today?
Not too good, my arthritis is pretty bad.
Oh, really?
No, O'Reilly.
You know, you should try pain-free.
Pain-free? What's that?
Pain-free is a chocolated analgesic chewing gum specially formulated for the relief of arthritis and rheumatism pain.
Sounds great, but how does it work?
Simple. Pain-free's special ingredients cut through arthritis pain just like this pool cue pokes through this lump of Wisconsin cheddar cheese.
I'll try it.
That'll be $11.95.
Hello, Mr. Connell.
Oh, hello, Mrs. O'Reilly. How's that arthritis pain? Oh,
terrible. Couldn't even pick up my toothbrush this morning.
Sounds like you need Stay Bright, the once-a-year toothpaste.
Sounds great, but how does it work?
Simple. Stay Bright's special ingredients remove yellow stains and mouth odor, just like I remove the money from your purse, and locks it away, so you'll never see it again.
Oh, really?
No, O'Reilly. Buy yourself a drugstore. You'll never regret it.
Tu me rends ça?
Tu es belle.
Toi aussi.
Il est quoi ton tocheur, tout de suite?
John? Louis? J'ai beaucoup que t'appeler, moi tu es Jerry Louis.
Quelle est ton tête tout de suite?
C'est le bonbon.
Méchant, méchant, méchant.
Et de le consoler, Jean, toi, ce qui?
De vous voir dire des mauvais amours.
Et donc, le cousin de Jean, bien senti vers Louis, et socialiste, hein, que l'on wacky.
Ça, avec le Louis, c'est capitaliste qu'on chante à la contexte.
Et de le consoler, tu joues.
Bon,
et toi? Bien.
Fais-moi le trigger.
Trigger.
Trigger, trigger. Je vais faire là tout de suite.
Mais nous passons le temps.
Oh, elle est coton.
And now to conclude our late night newscast, here's Earl Cannonbearer with a commentary. Earl?
My commentary tonight, Floyd, is in the form of a plea. I am pleading to all terrorist groups around the world. Enough is enough. You can't win. Terrorist acts such as bombing, hijacking, kidnapping, in general, scare tactics, to me are not a popular way to get your point across. And believe me, we get the point. I'm talking to the FLN, the PLO, Black September, the IRA. This is the 20th century, not the Spanish Inquisition. Let's talk, not kill. But first, you must surrender. If you refuse to surrender yourselves to the proper authorities, surrender to me, Earl Cannonbear. The number to call is 486-7934. I will personally guarantee you won't be harmed. We will talk about your plight. And I'll honestly try and see what I can do. I can't guarantee you won't be tortured for withholding information, but if you play ball with me, I'll play ball with you. But for now, let's stop the questionable tactics, huh? Floyd?
Don't all surrender at once, now.